farm in the hills of eastern Kentucky, in Hudson County, near the Shilling Creek. Tall tales.
Spring used to explode in these mountains, like a 2-pound charge of black powder hand tapped down a rat hole. After months of gray sky and that damp mountain cold, what bores into your bones like termites in a truckload of wood, it's your dogwood trees that finally announce what everything's been waiting for. Of course, dogwood's just the beginning. The spark what lights the fuse for spring, that's azaleas. When they get it going, you'd swear somebody took a whole handful of lit matches and scattered them all over these hills. Bible story is how old man Moses talked to a burning bush, but for my money, he was just conversing with a scarlet azalea in full bloom. Story just got a little expanded in the retelling, the way stories do. Fella once told me a story. He said these ain't real mountains here at all. That if you stood tall enough, you could see that it was all just one big mound that had been crisscrossed and cut up into so many hills and valleys by the spring runoff that it only looked like mountains. Leastways, that was his story. Only, I don't put no truck in stories anymore.
A friend. I'm a friend.
You shouldn't sneak up on a body like that.
Well, I know you don't think you're quite right. The fact of the matter is, if your life hadn't been in mortal danger right now, I would have walked right on by instead of saving your life.
My life?
Well, your mortal soul, leastways.
How you think that?
Why, staring into that creek like that. Why, I've heard it said from them that knows that the devil himself hides his bleak heart in the muddy bottom of slow-moving pools just like this.
You're just fooling.
And thus disguised, he lies in wait for an innocent virgin to come along.
Devil have to wait a mighty long time for one of those meat pies.
Not a fishy fellow the devil is.
There is no catfish.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I ain't never seen him. My daddy, he almost caught him once. So is Tommy. Why do you think he was lying?
Tommy, is that your brother?
Nah, he's my boyfriend. He's big. He thinks he is.
Might have heard it here.
Yeah, I just love them old trees, especially that oak right there. That's my favorite.
Ah, she's a beaut, all right.
Folks on here, they call that the tree oak. Because my great-great-granddaddy, Mal Caron, bought this land from the Indians.
Is that a fact?
That's what my daddy says. I don't think there's a tree in these hills themselves that comes close to touching it for its size. This is my favorite spot in the whole world. Not that I've seen a lot of the world, but my daddy, he took me to Louisville once when I was six. You ever been there?
Just so happens I was in Louisville 3 weeks ago.
Yeah? I've been to a whole heap of places that you're talking about.
I've been here and there.
Like where?
Well, places like Atlanta.
You've been to Atlanta, Georgia?
Hey, that ain't nothing. I've been to New York City.
No.
Yes, ma'am, and lived to tell the tale.
What's it like?
Well, I'll tell you. It's, well, it's pretty near indescribable. It's hundreds of buildings, each and every one taller than that granddad oak of yours.
No.
I don't think old JT would lie about something like that.
Yeah, JT, I was wondering what your name was.
Oh, Lord, isn't that just like me? Here I get to chowing on so much I plumb forgot to introduce myself. JT Wells at your service, ma'am. JT stands for just terrific.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Who do I have the pleasure of speaking to?
Marianne Norris.
Excuse me?
Marianne Norris. But most folks just call me
Mare. Mare? Well, I don't think that's a proper name for a pretty thing like you. Let me see here. You know what your name is in Spanish?
No.
Mariana.
Yeah.
That sounds about right, doesn't it? Got all the right colors and everything. Mariana.
Butternut squash right in the middle of your chest.
Damn it, Tommy! You put that gun up right now. Oh, I ain't never gonna speak to you for it.
pleasure, ma'am. Fact of the matter is, I'm here to see your daddy.
My pop?
Well, if your daddy's a Jed Rowan from Housing County, currently living up on Shilling Creek, I guess I am. I'm a storyteller. Jed, there ain't nothing like a home-cooked meal. Now, you might think a traveling man like myself eating at some fancy restaurant every day of the week's a man to be envied. But I tell you, there are times when I would trade it all, every green bean, almondine, and French this and French that, for a piece of cob-cured ham and red-eye gravy like an I had tonight.
It was all right, Ben.
All right? Man, the president don't eat better than this in the White House. You're our one fortunate man, Jed.
You reckon that, J.J.?
You got your independence. You ain't beholden to nobody for nothing. Here in God's country, why, you're a virtual king. Republican nobility.
Republican?
Figure speech, Jed. What I meant to say is that you and folks like you, well, your neighbors and all, why, they're what makes this country great.
Well, maybe, Mr. J.T., you'd like a drop of something stronger than coffee. To settle your stomach.
Well, not ordinarily, Jed. I'm not a drinking man, but seeing how this is a special occasion, I accept.
Ned, you get down that old mason jar and a couple of glasses.
Now, Jed, you know your stomach can't take it.
Lolly.
Fine, go ahead, but don't be waking me up in the middle of the night with them dreams of yours.
I know what I'm doing, woman.
Now, I do want to thank you folks for all your hospitality and all, but I know that nothing's for free in this world. So I suppose it's time that I, for my supper, as it were.
So JT starts in on telling us these inspiring stories about dreams and far-off places. Before you know it, it's getting real late, and he says he's got to be going.
Oh, you know, I wish there was some way that I could repay you folks for all of your hospitality. Seeing a family like yours so happy and so full of love for one another, it kind of makes you wonder, what if?
What if?
What if, God forbid, something should happen to one of you? Now, in the unpleasant event of your absence, Jed, you want your family to be looked after proper now, wouldn't you?
Well, of course.
It's a problem, but one for which I am happy to say there is a solution.
What's that?
I've been empowered by certain parties to purchase the mineral rights off a far-sighted Christian gentleman like yourself.
My mineral rights?
Yes, sir.
Oh, well, what exactly are we talking about here, J.T.?
Minerals is just a 25-cent word for rocks, actually.
Rocks? You mean someone wants to buy the rocks off of my land?
That's it, exactly. The people that I represent, Jed, are willing to pay you 50 cents an acre for the right to haul off all metallic and mineral substances and combinations thereof the same. Now, seeing how you've got... Well, how many acres do you say you got here, Jed?
Oh, 357 acres.
Why, that's $179 in cold, hard American cash.
Let me get this straight, J.T. I've been busting my back digging rocks under my damn fields for now I'm 40 years, and now you come tell me that people are willing to pay me money for that same privilege.
What can I tell you, Jed? There's a fool more every day. Well, here, read for yourself. It's all right here. Black. You know, the light's kind of bad here. Maybe you want me to help you out.
I can't do nothing with these old eyes of mine.
Essentially what this says is that for the sum in question, you, the owner, pass over the title to the minerals underlying your land. With the, with all the usual and ordinary mining rights. It says all that, but a lot longer. That's what it boils down to.
And that's all there is to it.
That's all.
Well, that sounds easy now, doesn't it? Now, where am I supposed to sign?
Right there.
Jed, I don't feel right about this.
What don't you feel right about, Lolly?
Jed, this land been in your family back before anyone can remember. And I don't think we ought to be selling it.
You heard it, Lolly. I ain't selling the land. I'm just selling the mineral rights.
I don't think you ought to be selling any part of it. Not even them rocks.
I understand your feelings, ma'am. boy myself. I share them. But I don't think that anybody in your family begrudge you for making a living off your land. What's important here is the land that stays in your family.
That's right.
Well, the man has got a point there, Lolly.
And why not make your life a little easier now, Lolly? Yeah, get yourself a new stove. Or maybe a pretty new dress for your dog.
We don't need new things. We got everything we need.
Lolly.
Look, now ordinarily I don't do this, but you know, your folks been so kind to me and all. Maybe I could see my way to 60 cents an acre.
75 cents?
Yes.
Shut up. JT and I are talking business. And he knows as well as I do that you cannot not let your personal feelings get in the way of business. Well, can you, JT?
Well, sir, you can. 75, huh? I might reckon you see my way to 75.
Good enough for me.
Kid, not enough money in the world.
Oh, look, Jed, your wife doesn't want you to go through with this. Maybe we'll just take
it. No, I make the decisions for this family, JT. And I say that's fine. Now, where do I sign?
Right there.
Oh, just out of curiosity, JT, what exactly about those usual and ordinary mining rights were you talking about?
Well, essentially, that means that they can excavate the land. You know, build a road here, there, if necessary, with your permission, of course. Use some of the local water.
Now, hold on just a minute right there. You never said anything before about cutting across my land or taking my water.
Chet, I promise you, you're hardly going to know they're here. I swear to God, Chet, they're going to be real careful with your land.
No, you want my mineral rights. Well, that's one thing. But I just can't see my way clear to all that other stuff. That roads and water. No, sir, no. Oh, less than you're willing to go a whole nother, let's see, quarter an acre.
What?
$1 an acre. And she's yours.
Hell, Jed, you could practically buy land in this area for that.
Well, you do it then. Of course, I thought you wanted the rights to a particular piece of land. Fine.
Are you trying to cut my throat, Jed?
Why, no, JT. But you did start out by saying how you wanted to do me and mine a favor.
Jed. I hope you don't take this the wrong way, but I ain't never met nobody like you before. You're one tough son of a bitch.
Well, I consider that a compliment. We do business?
Yeah, we do business.
$1 an acre.
$1 an acre?
Ooh, where do I sign?
Right there. But Jed, I can't go any higher.
Oh,
than
it ain't the money, Jed. I just don't know how to sign my name.
Oh, all you do is you make your mark. An X, whatever, right there. Here's your bank note.
Oh, $357.
I used to take that down to a bank, any bank. That little piece of paper is good as gold. Now, I do want to thank you folks for all your hospitality and all, but I best be going.
Will you stay the night?
That sure won't be no trouble.
No, I better be moving on.
Suit yourself.
Could use some help trying to find the road, though.
I'll take them, Jay.
All right. I do it myself. I'll probably get us both lost.
Thanks again for everything, Lolly. I will dream of your red-eyed gravy.
You're welcome.
Jen, you take care of yourself.
Now don't you worry about me, now.
I guess I won't, will I?
The Marianne.
Yes, sir.
It ain't all that far down there. Don't you be too long getting back. Yeah,
I won't. So, where are you heading?
Oh, just down the road a piece.
You think you ever gonna come back from here?
Not likely.
Lucky you.
I don't know. Seems like a real pretty place to meet, Marianne.
Boy, it's always the same. I love to do what you do. Travel around, meet folks, see new places.
Maybe my life isn't as glamorous as you might think.
No? I don't know. Wanna change?
Nah. Come on, let's get going. I can't take you with me, Marianne.
Why not?
Because this is where you belong. Swimming in this damn Kentucky moonlight on these mountains, that ain't really mountains. Now let's keep going.
I ain't showing you where that road is. You kissed me, sir.
What? You are your father's daughter, ain't you?
I wouldn't forget you.
Tony! Tony, what are you doing? Tony! Tony! Tony!
Change nothing. I can't take you with me, Marianne.
I know.
Oh, will you stop being so goddamn understanding?
Damn hillbillies.
I can cut your heart out with a rusted razor. As long as I smile and tell you another story, you're sitting there happy as pigs and shit.
Oh, Lord. I can't do this anymore. I can't do it. Everything that I've told you, it's all lies. Everything. Your poor Pappy, sitting there thinking he's slick as goose shit. Dollar an acre.
What a joke. He's sitting on 15, maybe 20,000 tons of coal an acre. Nothing, little hillbilly, just rocks, that's all. Millions of dollars worth of rocks.
Your daddy just sold to me for a lousy buck.
Millions!
No.
That ain't even the worst of it.
You ain't seen what they do to your land. Oh, I swear, Jed. I swear to God they're going to be careful with your land.
Yeah, they're careful, all right. Careful not to miss a trick. First they come in here and they cut down all your trees.
You know,
listen to me, goddammit.
First they cut down all your trees. They start digging. Up in the waste, fields, streams, wherever. When they're done,
when they've finished,
after they've squeezed every little bit out of your land, they just move on. Leaving your land colder and deader than that moon up there.
It isn't so.
Hell, it ain't.
But how can you do that to your own people? You a hillbilly just like me?
I ain't no hillbilly.
You said you was a boy off the creek.
That was a long time ago.
I'm whoever I say I am. I'm J.T. Wells. And I invent myself new every day. That's how I can do what I do. I just tell people the stories that they want to hear.
I smile when they want me to smile, and they believe what they want to believe.
Then what's left?
Of what?
Tell me what you want to hear, and I'll tell you why I don't care.
Take your boyfriend home, little hillbilly. At least he fights for what he believes in, or thinks he believes in. At least he believes in something. Take him home and marry him and live happily ever after. Here. I owe you. Tear it up. Tell your dad to tear up that bank note, too.
I told my pa what JT said. And pa said it was a lie. That JT was lying. That he beat JT in the deal. That JT was just trying to get out of it now. Trying to get his money back. I didn't tear it up. I didn't want to believe JT, so I chose not to. Like he said, I guess, people believe what they want to believe. He was right, of course. Probably the only time in his life JT Wells told the truth. And he wasn't believed. People say God ain't got a sense of humor. like he said they would. And they cut down all the trees. Without the trees, you get no color, no green explosion. And you got nothing to hold the land down, neither. What you got is a whole lot of rain moving a whole lot of mud. I try to tell my boy Joshua what it was like, so he'll know, so it won't be forgotten. He just looks at me and laughs. Mama's telling stories. Into a coal company camp where Thomas found work in the mines. I stood on my front porch that first day and looked out at my new home. Dust and noise and flame, like some old preacher's vision of hell. During the day, I swept and mopped the coal dust from the house. But every night while we slept, it crept back in with the shadow, like my daddy's bad dreams. And every morning, I started all over. Always there was this smell. Like you took a corn shuck mattress, soaked it in piss, covered it with garbage and coal, and set it on fire.
Mama.
We had five kids. Five sons. And every rainy season for 4 years, the fever came and took one of my boys. And I hold his hand and do whatever grieving mother has done since the beginning of time. I lie.
Mama.
It's gonna be all right, Joshua. Doctor's coming real soon. He's gonna pick you up.
Hand me dead man. Himself. typhoid, don't it?
You a doctor?
No, I just seen a lot of dead babies in my time.
Well, then, if you know typhoid, you know you can't do nothing.
Yeah. Of course, if the company built better privies, it might keep the people from doing their business in the drinking water. Might help, don't you think?
Privies don't mind cold.
Yeah, neither do dead babies.
50 cents.
I can't pay you anything right now, but if you could just load us for another couple weeks...
Hell, Marianne, you ain't hardly paid me nothing for what I've done for you for the past year.
Tommy, this is Abe Steinman. He's looking to board here.
You don't take boards. Why don't I just step outside and let you two talk about it?
It ain't charity, Tommy. He'd be paying us room and food.
I can carry my family.
Can you?
Doing the best I can, Mary.
I know that, Tommy. But we're just too far behind. I'm going to store that.
$2.50 a week, plus meals. A wife to do your laundry for an extra quarter a week.
Fair enough.
In advance.
I already paid your wife.
Dead fat. So you looking to hire on here at Blue Star?
Oh, thank you.
Well, company can always use another slate picker, I reckon.
I'm hoping to hire on as a miner.
A miner? Well, they hired worse, I guess.
Blue Star a good company?
All the same, ain't they?
Good. Book the truth there, brother.
Stan. You a Jew?
Make a difference to it?
Hell. I work for niggers. Cole don't care. Neither do I.
You from West? You ever been to West Virginia? Colorado?
Elmer T? No, sir. I ain't been there.
Blue Star don't need no troublemakers.
No, sir.
You know this man, Jackson?
No, sir. Not exactly yet. He's family. On my mother's side. Second cousins or something.
Well, you load your 10 a day, 6 days a week. Keep your head down and your nose clean. You'll do just fine. You make any trouble, you wish you never met. We're on the script system here. Company money only. Get paid every Saturday. We got everything you need out of the company store and the company hall house. Got any questions?
When do I start?
A week from tomorrow. Jackson. Company can't. can't write you no more credit. You owe for coal, food, funeral expenses, and you owe for everything.
Yes, sir. Well, we took off this border. It should help some.
You mean your mother's cousin? You people. You still think you can teach your old granny to suck eggs?
My boy Joshua, he's about ready to start work. He's old enough.
Another slave picker's not going to dig you out of the hole you in. Mind you, if it were up to me. Well, you just can't let personal feelings get in the way of business now, can you?
No, sir.
Yeah, maybe we can make up some sort of deal. I pay well for certain kinds of information.
Information?
Yeah. You know what I'm talking about. Everybody's got to have a lookout. I think you better look out for your family.
Winston calls a piece of work, ain't he?
We have a brother over in Carlton. Got killed last year in a strike. Been shitting himself ever since.
Sounds to me like they killed their own brother.
Where'd you say you were from exactly?
Oh, I didn't.
Well, if you was,
West Virginia.
That ain't what you told, Mr. Winston.
No, I guess I lied.
I've heard a bunch of people got killed in West Virginia near Pan Creek.
Yeah? I heard they got themselves a union. Listen, I want to thank you for what you did down there.
Because, look, let you and me get one thing straight. I ain't your brother. I ain't your cousin. And I ain't your friend. If you was on fire, I wouldn't take the time to piss on you. Right now, my family needs money. As soon as we don't need that money or you can't pay, you're gone.
Listen, all I was trying to do is
say nothing. Don't tell me nothing. I don't want to know.
Fight it hard.
Yeah, that's right.
Fight this thing. You'll win it. Fight it!
I'll take him. What do you want?
Nothing.
You want something here, don't you? Don't tell me you don't.
I'm just making talk, that's all.
You one of them organizers, ain't you?
Yes, ma'am.
Don't you bring no trouble on my house.
Listen, you told me to, and I'll leave now.
You bring trouble in here, and I'll make you wish the company had caught you. We didn't need the money. I'd throw you out right now.
What's going on?
Mama. Joshua.
His fever's broke.
So Joshua got better. Before you know it, he was up and about wanting to know about the border. Of course, him and Abe were soon thicker and thicker. Abe talking to him about the organizing going on in other company camps, and Joshua just thinking it was some grand adventure. I wish it was.
Greetings, Brother Jackson. You wanted to see me?
Yes. I have a problem here. My boy, Joshua, he's of age, wanting to go in the mines, but I can't seem to lay my hands on the purchase.
Uh-huh. And what do you suppose happened to the old one? Gets it burnt up in a fire or something?
Something like that.
Damn fires. How old is he?
14.
But there's a lot of people work involved, you understand. A lot of expenses.
How much?
$3.
Well, to tell you the truth, I only got a dollar in cash on me. I was hoping I could pay off with it.
What's going on
well,
here?
Well, I don't know. I probably got to make a special trip down to Morgan.
Tommy.
You got to file birth certificates at the county courthouse.
I can maybe scrape together $1.50.
What are you doing, Tommy?
Cash, not scrape, right?
Tommy!
What?
He's
what do you
too
want?
Young!
How soon can you do it?
Tomorrow?
He got him a birth certificate. I'll show you!
$1.50 is fine.
I want it tomorrow.
Bless you, Mr. Pearson.
He got him one. Here!
Well, he ain't got him one now. Don't you ever shame me like that again! Just too far behind.
We can make it. I can make it work. We got what Avery did.
We don't need him. We don't need charity from that sort.
Then you got Josh.
You got that right.
What are you doing, Tommy?
I'm doing what I should have done a long time ago.
Joshua, you can wait outside.
Joshua, you stay right where you are. Right now. Joshua, you want to be a miner, don't you? Like your dad? Tell your mom. Go on, tell her.
Sure, I guess.
There. That settles.
He can do better.
Better.
Go on, say it. Better than what?
Better in mining.
What you mean is better than me.
Better than you.
Leave me alone!
You! I want you out of my house! You're here when I get back! I'll kill you.
Okay, I'll go. But you and me both, I ain't the problem here.
I'm okay.
Don't suppose you know someone needs a board.
I'm sorry, Abe.
You ain't got nothing to apologize for. Not to nobody.
Who am I gonna do now?
This isn't over, Marianne. Not by a long shot.
No.
Listen, when the company came in and took this land away from your family, it took them years. They was real patient. Now that's just what you gotta be. Take care of your mama, boy. She's something special.
Everything went fine for the first week or two. And then one day we all heard it. First a low rumble, and then an explosion. All of us women knew what it meant, just none of us wanted to say it.
Joshua!
Name's the missus.
He ain't going back down there. You neither.
He's going back. We're all going back. We always go back.
What do you think, Tommy?
What do you think?
I think the Blue Star thinks that a ton of coal is worth more than Tommy Jackson and his boy combined. Willie Baker?
What do you think we ought to do,
Tommy? Earl Weiss?
What do you think we ought to do? You son of a bitch. You ain't from around here. You don't know nothing about here!
Sam Whalen.
I've been in 100 different coal camps, Tommy. This one ain't any different.
Tom Allen.
You're not alone in this, Tommy.
Frank Whalen.
Don't fight me, Tommy.
Leave me alone.
No, I'm not.
You fight me, you fight her, you fight everyone but them. Why don't you fight
because
them?
Because I don't know how.
I know how. Organize the men. Pull everyone out. No one goes back.
Then what?
They'll bring in scabs. Try and replace you. Then we can't organize. We chase off.
Then we can't chase off.
We kill them. We're gonna need guns.
Ain't that what the union does?
Listen, Tommy. This operator's got this county locked up. Tired to please that ass. I can't pull anything in here. But I got money. Got someone who ain't too particular about who he sells to. I'll just buy him.
There's a miner. Does some bootleg. Supposed to run guns inside. On the ship.
Set it up. What's the matter?
He's a nigger.
Cole don't care. Why should you? Biggs,
ma'am?
I understand you can get us some rifles. Why don't get us a union together?
So what happened the other night won't happen again.
Well, I'm not sure if you ever mind it. Six of them were colored. One of them was Serena's brother.
Sorry for your loss, ma'am. If we had a union, this sort of thing wouldn't happen.
You know, they're going to bear my brother separately from those white
lines. Ain't that just like the company? Keep us apart in death as well as in life. Things don't have to be this.
How you feel, Tommy? Things ain't never gonna change.
Only for those too scared to make a change. Listen, Cassius, I ain't gonna lie to you and pretend we don't need those rifles. We do. But whatever else you may have thought of in your life, the union is different.
Different? What you gonna go and sell me next? Jesus and Rose?
Jesus was a working man.
Yeah, look what they did to him.
He didn't have no rifles. Now listen, Cassius. With or without the rifles, we'd be glad to have them. Nowhere to find us.
What?
That ain't seem like a piece of rain.
Because he tipped his hat to you and he called me little. They always nice to us when they need us. He's a Jew looking about them.
Same difference to me, maybe.
Maybe the sun's gonna rise in the west and I wouldn't be laying no money down on. White folks want to kill each other, I say more power to them. I ain't saying it's rap. I'm just saying that's how things is. I wish they was different.
What shouldn't all of three of the saddest words they is?
Joining that damn union ain't gonna bring your brother back, three.
No, it ain't, but I got a fool for a husband going down to those mines every day. And a 10-year-old boy who wants to be just like his dad. And if joining the union keeps him alive, that'd be enough for me.
Lord, what I do to get stuck with you.
You're a lucky man, Cassius. You're a lucky man. And so Cassius and Sarita joined us, and Silas and Lucy. And the word spread like wildfire, and every man and woman in that camp joined us. And the mines shut down, and the steam whistle went rusty. We moved into a hollow near the tracks, where people put up tents and just left out in the open like some big church. Abe wasn't sure if we was gonna win. And we was all scared, I guess. Especially when the company sent in a train with machine guns to shoot us off. We was lucky. Only two people got hurt. Thomas says we should be getting some guns real soon.
You want here, Jack?
I want my job back.
Then the strike. strike on, or didn't you notice?
Strike wasn't my idea.
Whose was it?
Look, I just don't want to hurt nobody.
Me neither. I think this thing got blown way out of proportion by a bunch of outsiders. Take those people out. Things get more reasonable. I got the damn army coming in here.
The army?
Yeah. Did that visit last night with something? Little tanks rolling in.
Everybody gets their job back.
I can't promise.
That's the deal. Everybody gets their job back.
I need a name.
Look, I don't want no one to get
hurt. I need a name and a place.
I want your word. No one gets hurt.
Show, gentlemen. Everybody does exactly what I tell them. You got that?
Got it.
You got that, Tony?
I got it.
David.
Where's Carl?
Hey, couldn't make it.
Problem?
Said the person I used to deal with.
Hey, guns is guns, gentlemen, and cash is cash. You got one, I got a shitload of the other.
I don't like this. Let's go.
Let's do what's got.
Hey, wait, maybe.
Lying.
That's the
Tommy Jackson. He ain't no quitter. And I thought, no, he ain't. When they tore down my stars, I'd have give up right then. But you wouldn't let me. I never loved you. They can tear these mountains apart, and Tommy Jackson won't quit on me. I know you loved our boy, and I love you for that. I put up with the drinking, and you hit me because I knew deep down in your heart you grieved like I did. And I reckon I didn't think I deserved any better. You wasn't never kind, Tommy. You wasn't never wise. But I never thought you was a quitter. And then you put on me. My name is Rowan. Mary Ann Rowan. I have one son, Joshua Rowan. And this man is a stranger to me.
Joshua! Joshua! Joshua!
I'm prepared to fight any of this gun, fellas, with or without guns. But I ain't prepared to fight the whole damn U.S. Army. Strike's over.
Been an accident. That's hard. Watching your son go down in that dark mine in the morning and not knowing whether you'll ever see him again. That's hard. Bearing a baby, you just... I've buried four children in this ground. You hear me? Four babies. I didn't have a choice about that. But I've got a choice now, and I ain't buried another one. They can bring in 100 damn armies and it can't be nothing compared to what we've known. It won't never stop unless we say it stops. And I say it stops. Right here. Right now. Stand up. Thank you.
side are you on? It is 34 years later, November 1954, Houghton County, Kentucky, in and around the UMW Union Hall, near the Blue Star Mine. Which side are you on?
And so, the Union became my life. Mama passed the torch on to me, and I became Union President. And contract negotiations took up all my time. Labor and management never seemed to see eye to eye. James Winston here, owner of the Blue Star Mine, was always trying to get the company a better deal at the expense of the workers. That's why I hired on Franklin Biggs here as a community rep, so he could look after his people. Because if those workers were black, it was all the worse for them. Still, it was always a challenge. Nothing is non-negotiable. And I want a 30% reduction in the layoffs.
I don't see what's so funny, Mr. Winston. My people's hurting real bad, and I don't know what these new layoffs will do.
Is that a threat?
No, sir.
Look here, gents, I think we can work something out here.
Okay.
15%
over the next 3 years. But I get your word. Both ends. No walkouts. No slowdown, no wildcat strike. Coal keeps moving out. We in agreement?
Just one more thing. The safety issue.
I can't stop production right now.
You got a dust problem here, James. And we in the middle of the goddamn explosion season.
I need at least 6 weeks.
I'm not going to endanger my neck.
Well, that's going to put him out of a job, that's all. Oh, forget it.
What
up, baby? I need 6 weeks, and you have to guarantee your membership a job for the next 3 years.
3 weeks.
Oh,
3 weeks. And I want an extra ventilation system in those mines this week.
It's on order from Louisville. As soon as I get it, it goes in.
It goes in this week, James. If you have to rent a U-Haul and drive it down there yourself, this week.
All right.
So? Like a salesman working a hard sell, I started working out deals between the union and the national reps, which didn't leave me much time for my wife Margaret and my son Scotty, who just got back from fighting in Korea. I got Scotty a job as a union field rep. Of course, I expected him just to do his job, not ask any questions, but he got an independent streak in him. Started poking his nose into things that he didn't need to. Wasn't long before he was going to lead a wildcat strike because I couldn't get an extra ventilation system installed in the mines.
So busy lately with one thing and another, I just couldn't
look, Dad. You don't have to explain. It's just that sometimes I wonder if you'll ever have any time for me or Mother.
This contract, though, is so important. It could mean so many more new jobs for us. There's just so much at stake here.
I get it. It's just that I've been home from the war for over 6 months now, and not once have we all sat down and had dinner together.
Well, I'll tell you what. Tomorrow, I'll take you and your mother out for a nice new dinner, okay? But first, I gotta iron this up. All right, boys, we in order? The new contract. We got us a salary increase and a coal royalty. Now, that coal royalty, that should build us a new hospital here in Houghton County. That's the good news. The bad news is that it's gonna be a lot more layoffs.
Josh, we all appreciate what you've done for us, but this layoff business is just too damn much. I don't see how we can recommend this contract.
Look, Kelvin, we got this industry-wide recession here. We pushed the BCOA as far as we could. The National knows what it's doing.
I'm with Kelvin. This layoff business is
bullshit.
Membership ain't gonna take too much more of this. I mean,
hey, look, Chuck, we all on the same team here, all right?
Look, Josh, they just fired my brother last week. 28 years in the mines, and they just threw his ass out. He don't know nothing but coal. Now what am I going to tell him, Josh, huh? What are we going to tell our people?
The National is aware of the problem, Chuck. And they'll take care of it.
Let's hope they do a better job at that than they do with safety.
You got a problem at Blue Star? Let's go, fellas.
I've been complaining about the dust down there for months.
We're wandering here.
Cooperation's dry as a box of matches.
That's enough, Calvin.
Who'd you talk to?
Joshua said he'd take care of things personally.
Let's get back to the contract.
You can.
Calvin.
Why didn't you tell me this?
Because it's being taken care of.
No, well, you heard Calvin. It's not been taken care of. Now, why didn't you tell me?
Because I didn't want a three-hour argument about it.
Where are you going?
I'm going down to the Blue Star right now to pull those men out of there.
The hell you are.
Come on, Calvin. Sit down, Calvin.
Now, look here, boy. I gave my word there would be no wildcat strikes here.
If you pull those men out of there, you're going to kill this contract.
I don't give a damn about this contract.
Now, look here, boy.
Look, goddammit, there's more at stake here
than a goddamn piece of paper.
You're right about that.
Let's go, Calvin.
Sit down to both of you.
I can't, Dad. Now, why won't you come down there and help me pull those men out of there?
Scotty, boy, you are either with us or against us.
I gotta go take care of my men.
You walk out of here, you turn your back on this union, I swear to God, I will cut you out of it like a boil!
I guess we were both stubborn. Scotty went down into the mine to pull those men out. That's when it happened. Coal dust explosion. They never had a chance. Down in the mine.
What was he doing down there?
He went down there to pull the men out.
Why?
It was unsafe.
Why were they down there?
Nobody meant for this to happen, Margaret. It was an accident, Margaret.
Don't touch me! No! What did you do, Joshua? You killed him. You all killed him!
It was an accident. That ain't fair, Margaret.
Shut up! Would you just shut up? I am so sick of all of you! I want my Scotty, Joshua! I want my Scotty!
Brett's gonna want to hear something.
Oh, you better not blame me. We're all to blame.
I'd like to say a few words to the press. What happened here at Blue Star is a tragedy. There'll be an investigation, I promise you. A thorough investigation. But what it can say is, I can say that. Now, I will say that since Blue Star has always been a safe and responsible operation with a good record. What this tragedy says to me is it's something we all know, but none of us like to admit. Isn't it mine? And it's a dangerous business. We all just have to live with that.
Here, the names are missing. Bob Whalen, E.O. Baker, Carl Nolan, Chad Dawkins, Gus Mayo, Thomas Hayes, C.C. Baker, Carl Berry, Jack Fox, Willie Allen, Bob Lynch, Scott Rowland.
war on poverty.
21 years later,
the year was 1975. The original Rowan homestead near the Shilling Creek. Surrounding fields, now abandoned, are mostly broom sedge and hard rock with an occasional pine tree. It is spring. The war on poverty.
I keep having this dream. In my dream, I'm crossing some kind of a desert. It's all full of slate and ashes and dust. I hear Scotty calling to me, and I run after his voice until I come to this river. And somehow, I know it's the Shilling, but it ain't like that pathetic sewer you see down there today. No, this is deep and wide. Full of fast-moving muddy water. I see Scotty on the other side, but I can't get to him. And then I notice he's not alone. He's standing there with my name. I haven't thought of Tommy in years, but there he is. Got his mining clothes on, coal dust all over his face. And I don't realize till I see him how much I miss him. And Mama's standing right beside him, got an arm around him. And then behind him is this whole bunch of people I don't know. Oh, they're talking to me and yelling something, but I can't hear it. The river's loud and the wind is blowing that dust around like crazy. I don't know if I could just hear what they were saying, I would know what I was supposed to do. I'm supposed to do something, see? Something, but I can't hear it. I can hear Scotty. And then I'll wake up.
Oh.
They had no damn business being here anyway. This is private property.
Hey, these balls are big.
Joshua! Franklin!
Over here!
Where the hell are you?
This way.
Oh, I can't see the damn thing around here. Who? What the hell are you shooting at?
Daniel Boone here trying to scare off some poachers.
They were grave robbers, Franklin, not poachers.
Grave robbers? A big local industry nowadays. Well, hell, what else is there since the mine shut down?
You mean there's real money in that?
Yeah, I don't see nothing about no cemetery on this map.
These mountains is full of bones. Everywhere you walk,
I don't know where the hell we are. You guys know
The
ash end of nowhere.
I do it.
I'm serious. Let me see here.
That looks like be a piece of the Shilling right over there.
Sure. That means Morgan must be that way, right?
We just came from over there. What's the matter with you?
Joe?
Well, you got me.
What the hell?
You mean we're really lost?
Jesus Christ.
Oh, look now, boys. Instead of stumbling around here in the fog, why don't we just wait here till it burns off something? We'll figure it out. Oh, great. I mean, this is real great.
Well, I hope you're satisfied, Joshua. We could have settled this all back in Morgan, but no. You gotta come out here and see the property.
Well, I think we ought to know what we're getting into before we sell it, that's all.
Well, now we see it, just like I told you, a garbage dump. Now, can we finish it, please?
There's no point in getting sentimental.
Yeah, it's a hospital.
Jeez. Well, I'm not going to be pushed into something here, Jay, so you just back off.
Jay, why? Can we get this 5 minutes? Five minutes. Come on. What's wrong, Josh?
Last couple of months, I've been just thinking about things going on over and over.
Old stuff. You know.
Like what?
The day we unsealed the mine? The service? That list of names that seemed to go on forever. All those women, all them widows and daughters standing there dressed in black, like so many crows looking right through me. And then Stucky handing me Scotty's watch and away, not being able to shake my hand or even look me in the face. Just gotta let it go, Doc.
Well, we good at that, ain't we, Franklin?
Yeah, we real good at just letting it go.
Christ, Franklin, if we had something here, we had a community here, you and me. Look at it now. Morgan's a damn ghost town.
Let the Consolidated come in and tie the whole damn thing over.
It'll be like we never were. It'll be like what Cassius and Marianne, everything we tried to do here never was. I remember that big meeting we had in Morgan. You remember that first year after Strat, remember? I remember my mom and your daddy standing on that big platform made out of wagons, and they're talking to this huge crowd from all over the Cumberland. And we'd be looking over this sea of people like the mountains in bloom in the spring my mom used to tell me about in her dreams. And they're all holding hands and swaying back and forth, and it was all one thing. All of us. And them mountains. And I remember thinking, there ain't nothing we can do. Nothing.
In the past, now.
Hey, look what I got here!
What?
Ow, look at this shit. Looks like a piece of buckskin.
Let me see.
Yeah. Hey, where's those guys working with the case tomorrow?
Uh-oh. Over yonder.
Over yonder, yeah.
Like stars, don't it? Mm. Like the Milky Way. Like all the stars in the sky kind of was sewn onto that one piece of deer hide.
Mm-hmm. Open it up.
What are you going to do next? Oh, damn. Gee, it's a baby. How old do you think that is?
200 years or more. It ain't been Indians in the Cumberland for over 200 years or more.
Well, it can't be. Look at it.
Hey, I read about stuff like this. Greek stuff. Day once I buried a guy in Europe.
Well, the buckskin must have kept the water out and preserved it.
You know what? I know a collector who'd pay thousands for something like this here.
You sell it?
I found it.
On hospital land?
It was. Was hospital land. Now don't get on your high horse with me.
Oh, come on, Jay.
Hey, I'm not kidding. Don't start with me. Fine, Jay. It's yours. Yeah.
No, it's not. No. You put her back.
Hell no.
Then I will. You give her here.
No.
Give it to me, James.
Give it to me. Look, what is
the matter?
Give it to me.
No.
You crazy dog.
I'm not kidding.
What's the difference?
It makes a difference. But now you put her down.
Josh.
No, Franklin, no.
Everybody, let's just calm down. Jay, put the bass down.
Do it. Go on, you put her down.
Jay, put the bass down.
about, don't you, Franklin? Huh?
And it's all my fault, isn't it? It's bullshit! We're all to blame for what happened here. We're all to blame. God, he's dead.
You think we're just gonna have to live with that?
I'm trying, James.
Hell you are. I'll get this land without you. It'll take a little longer, damn it. I'm gonna get a court order.
I know he can make this work without me, Franklin, but he can't do it without you. Don't let him do it.
It ain't gonna make no difference.
We gotta try, don't we?
I think so.
It's cold down there, baby.